last person to ever try to be like this died 30 days later. I pray for you. Love is wise, bro. I be in here with Young Thug.
She doing too much, y'all. She said she gonna be. She said, I'm gonna be down there with Young Thug and Lil Woody. She can drink. What is she talking about? Supposed to be what y'all looking at now, this young lady. Capping, talking about she gonna be down in jail with Lil Woody and Young Thug. Why she bringing their name up?
Yeah.
I'm praying for you right now. Don't talk to me. Like, I'm really praying for your spirit.
Why is he talking to her? Just take her to the station. Later alone and go on and turn it in. Agitating the situation. God, where you start the car anyway? You shouldn't have started the car no way. Because he know he did it wrong. Why in the world he stopped that car to talk to her? Anyway, before he got down there. She said, I'm going down there with Young Thug and Lil Woody anyway. Wright Street. She didn't cooperate with you, did she? Why he leave her out there like that? Oh, city of Atlanta. City of Atlanta. Oh, he left her in that car that long? Y'all, the video you are watching, it just supposed to be one of young. Well, she alleges that she's one of Lil Woody. She said that she's going to be down there with Lil Woody and Young Thug. Supposed to be one of their girls. That's what she claims. Girl, when they process you, it's gonna take you a while to get out of there.
What's your name?
You don't know her. To say that's why she act drinking like that. Just tell them your name. Okay, y'all. The young lady who y'all just saw just a few minutes ago, she is a Douglas County judge. Uh-huh. And she was arrested at Buckhead Nightclub. Okay? That's what she is. That's why she didn't want to tell them nothing. Okay?
Look here. Of a Douglas County judge. It shows probate judge Christina Peterson's encounter with police before, during, and after she was arrested and booked into the Fulton County Jail.
Take me where you want to take me. No, take me. And I don't care. You don't need that identification. You have locked people up and you have picked up dead bodies when you don't know who bodies it was, but you picked them up. Take me where you need to take me.
That's Peterson you saw in the back of the squad car. There she is again engaging with police before she's rushed to the ground and placed in handcuffs. The night this happened, an Atlanta police officer was working a security detail at the Red Martini Lounge in Buckhead. Police say the officer overheard some commotion, stepped in to de-escalate it, and that's when Peterson physically got involved with police. Police also showed video of what happened when they got her out of the squad car.
Stop, I got it. I can walk on my own. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. I got it. I can walk on my own. Don't touch me.
Charged with simple battery against a police officer and felony willful obstruction of law enforcement by use of threats of violence. Buckhead Nightclub.
Tonight, Judge Christina Peterson is facing felony charges for allegedly hitting an officer. And then his first reporter, Patrick Quinn, is live outside the
a judge, yeah.
Club. That's in Buckhead. Patrick, two witnesses have now come forward saying the judge was not the aggressor.
Alan, and we were able to talk with those two witnesses today. They say that Douglas County Probate Judge Christina Peterson shouldn't be punished, but instead praised after a fight broke out here in Buckhead, and now the attorney of Peterson wants all of those charges dropped. Moments after a fight outside a Buckhead nightclub, police arrest a woman on the ground.
Yeah!
That's Christina Peterson.
Why did you treat her like that?
Peterson is a Douglas County Probate Judge, now fighting for justice herself. But today, her attorney, Marvin Arrington Jr., told me, for now, Peterson is not talking.
I'm sure she would love to say some things today to clear her name, but I think that Ms. Love and Ms. Kelly have done that for her.
Peterson was booked into jail Thursday facing charges of simple battery against a police officer and felony willful obstruction of law enforcement by use of threats of violence. But Arrington now wants Atlanta police to drop those charges. For two witnesses, say Peterson was not the aggressor, but instead coming to the defense of a woman attacked.
And she was the only one to help me. She the only one that was grabbing to help me.
Alexandria Love said while waiting in line for food, a fight broke out. She said a man pushed her to the ground and punched her in the face. That's when Love says Peterson jumped in to help her. Madison Shannon Kelly was there too.
And we did not understand why she got locked up and the gentleman that did this got away freely. He just walked away. Like it was nothing.
Arrington Jr. suggested police got confused and misinterpreted Peterson's efforts to help. Kelly then chased after the man, who Arrington says has not been arrested or charged in the fight.
Five police cars came. They all left when they took her. I had to sit there and call 911. It just feel horrible that nobody actually helped me. I've never been in a situation where I
Again, that was Alexandria Love, who says she was a part of that fight right outside this Buckhead nightclub. Now,
y'all, I don't know what's going on with the Young Thug case, but she did bring up Young Thug name in the car and Lil Woody. Yes, she did. And, oh, Lord, she's a judge in a probate court. She was at a nightclub, and you heard the girl say that she was protecting them. Lord have mercy, y'all. Why did she bring up Young Thug and Woody?
Probate Judge Christina Peterson in Atlanta News First. Bridget Spencer has been on top of this story all day. She's joining us live from Douglas County. Bridget, what is the judge saying tonight?
Tori, Carly, the judge says she was simply trying to help a woman who was being attacked by another man. However, Atlanta police say that she attacked one of their own that night.
Stop playing with me,
chaos erupting outside Red Martini on Thursday morning. Atlanta police now releasing the body camera footage of Douglas County Judge Christina Peterson's arrest.
Take me where you want to take me. No, take me. And I don't care. You don't have any identification. You have locked people up and you have picked up dead bodies when you don't know who bodies it was, but you picked them up. Take me where you need to take me.
The judge claims she was trying to be a good Samaritan and help a woman who was being attacked. Meanwhile, Atlanta police say she hit this responding officer at this moment in the video.
Let her
They say the judge was also not cooperating while in custody.
You can Google me and find me anywhere in America.
At a press conference, two witnesses defended Peterson, saying she saved a woman's life.
She didn't mean to hit the officer. The officer swooped in and grabbed me up. When she see him grabbing me, she didn't know it was the officer. Stop touching me.
The judge was booked and charged with simple battery against an officer and obstruction, all which her attorney says needs to be dropped.
They simply want to know why the man was not arrested and why was Judge Peterson arrested for simply trying to be a good Samaritan.
We tried getting in touch with the judge to discuss the body camera footage, but we were unsuccessful. Now, we also, in addition, did call a number that was listed for the judge. She was on the phone, however, she did hang up on us. Meanwhile, we are also learning that their lead attorney says that they want DA Fonnie Willis to also take a deep dive and a deep look at this.
What? She said she want Fonnie Willis to deep dive and look into this? Wow. What is going on in Atlanta?